Good morning. It's Kathryne Gardette coming to you live from Cafe Vivace with Soapbox Media, Open Newsroom. You know what today is. Friday, February 14th, Valentine's Day. Do you have plans for your sweetheart? I hope so, because tonight, Eugene Goss, which would be a fabulous music ensemble to listen to, is sold out. But if you can get your sweetheart to hold off one day and come in on Saturday, Mandy Gaines is here. And if you live in Walnut Hills and you've not made your lunch plans, Little Fang is here today. Let's just say you can have some miso soup. I may need to stay here long enough to have some miso soup to go home. But it is here today until 2 o'clock, 11 a.m. to 2 o'clock. You can come get lunch. It's great. We are in our fourth week of Open Newsroom, and I am here today with my friend, neighbor, colleague, Margaret, and we are going to share why we love Walnut Hills with you today, aren't we, Margaret?
We sure are. This community has been my home for 5 years, and I hope to make it my home for at least another 5, 10, 15, 20. I love this community.
Before you know it, you'll be here 30 years like me.
That's the hope.
That is the hope. So I know, similar to me, you've like come into the neighborhood and you've just immersed yourself in what this neighborhood has to offer. Can you tell me what's the vibe of Walnut Hills that just drew you in and caused you to fall in love?
I have never lived somewhere where almost all of my neighbors are just like waking up every day eager to do something active to make the community better. People in Walnut Hills live and breathe Walnut Hills. It's just a very, very passionate place to be, and it's also a super diverse community, which I love. I can walk out the door and see 10 people who look, think, act nothing like me, and they're all kind. It's just a very welcoming community as well, so I can't think of a more appealing place to live.
It is great. So there is also a lot of, in Walnut Hills, we say you can live, work, play, and pray here. And I know you do all of the above. So if you'll tell us about your work and how that is. And she works in the first Carnegie Library built in Cincinnati, as a little FYI.
Yes. So as a disclaimer, before I talk about my work with the library, I do want to say that everything that I'm about to say are my own views, and they don't reflect the mission or vision of the Public Library of Cincinnati and Hamilton County, its board of directors, or its staff. So I found myself working at the Walnut Hills branch of the Public Library about a year and a half ago. I was fresh out of graduate school. I got my master's in history at Miami University, and I did all of my practical work in archives and special collections. And as I was emerging from the full-time student process, I thought it would be great to try my hand at some public librarianship, because I'd never really done work where I was interacting with the public to answer their research questions directly. And I didn't know that I was going to fall in love with this work, and that it was going to make me a more civic-minded, public servant kind of person, and it's really humbled me to see that there are so many types of research questions that help make people's lives better, not just answering questions about things that happened a long time ago, but questions about how can I make today better? How can I put food on the table for my family next week? Mm-hmm. We do a lot of social services work. We send fax documents to the Hamilton County Job and Family Services office on behalf of our neighbors. And it's just a privilege and a joy to be able to do something that I know makes that person's day actionably better. It feels so good. Every day I leave that building, I feel like I've made a real difference.
It's very appreciative. I will let you know that out in the community, there's a project that Margaret's been working on, that it's a library project that she started but it is known throughout the community, and people are starting to say, how do I get on the Walnut Hills Weekly? So tell us a little bit about Walnut Hills Weekly.
So Walnut Hills Weekly is a weekly newsletter that I put out that is, to my knowledge, the only comprehensive list of free and reduced cost events in 45206. I saw the need initially because people were asking me questions about where soup kitchens were. And we do have a list of soup kitchens that is put out by the main library, and we place that on our community table every month. But I noticed that the Walnut Hills Soup Kitchen was not on the list, and I thought, okay, where can people get food? So I started making calls to churches and nonprofits, and I began to discover that there's a lot more happening here that's free than just a meal. There are also something like a dozen different Narcotics Anonymous meetings happening every week all around the neighborhood. And then as the newsletter started to grow, I thought, what if I started to include fun things for people to do in the neighborhood? So I began to list events that are happening at the Art Museum in Eden Park and also Woodburn Games. They have all these wonderful, super nerdy, amazing game nights, playing things like Magic the Gathering, which I grew up with. So there's just all kinds of things happening in the neighborhood, and I want people to know about them. So I will say, if you're watching this and you have a free or reduced cost event coming up in Walnut Hills, please don't hesitate to reach out to me. I can be found at the public library in person, or you could also give us a phone call at 369-6053, and we'll make sure that your message gets to me.
One of the other items that Margaret and I have in common is that we are both singers. It's one of those little-known talents. Did you go to school for singing?
I did. My undergraduate degree is in vocal performance and music composition. I studied at Capital University Conservatory in Columbus, Ohio, and it was just a fabulous experience. It taught me to be a better choral singer, and right out of school, I started teaching. So I have taught private voice lessons for coming up on 17 years.
That's great. Time flies when you're having great conversations. We could talk for another half hour, but we know that you probably need to get back to something else. But as we were talking about all the different things that happen in Walnut Hills, we know that we are a food desert. And also, Soapbox Media has a project called Ground Source, where they are gathering information to assist us with where you can buy food in Walnut Hills, but what food do we actually need to still have here? So I'm gonna ask each of you to text hello to 513-230-6899. Again, it's 513-230-6899. You will assist us in knowing how we can be a win-win community for all who reside here. It's Kathryne Gardette with Margaret. We've been to you live from Cafe Vivace, supported by a Facebook Journalism Project grant. Have a great morning.